Yeah, welcome back to Sunday Brunch Live. We're just about to go with Pentatonix Scott and Kirsty. Before that, though, you've got some Halloween pictures.
We have. Your Halloween costume pictures. First up is Eleanor from Saltburn. Makes a pretty convincing little red riding hood with a basket full of pumpkin spice brownies, which is one of my recipes.
That's good. I like that outfit.
That is good. Yeah. I like that outfit. It was Day of the Dead for Polly Ann and Ellie Mae from Ballyronan at their school Halloween disco. It's good to see everyone's doing it this year.
Yeah,
up in the ante. Very good. And Sadie from Bingwall is celebrating her first Halloween dressed in the Little Witch outfit made by her mum, Teresa.
Very cute. Keep sending those in, plus questions for any of today's guests to at Sunday Brunch C4 or Sunday Brunch at channel4.com.
It'll be nice to, actually, on the pictures, because I love all the ones with the little kids on. Yeah, dogs dressed up in Halloween costumes. We love those as well, don't we?
I absolutely love dogs dressed up, yeah. how's your cooking?
I have zero experience in cooking, actually.
Really? I like cooking.
Yeah, she can cook.
What do you cook?
I like cooking. Well, I like baking more.
Really?
Yeah.
What sort of things? Just cakes?
Like cupcakes and cookies. And I like making cakes, but then you make a cake and, like, you have to have people to eat it. So I always, like, make the cake and I'm like, all right, I guess I'll do it that way.
Because I think baking's really therapeutic and quite nice about kind of like, you know, creamy, buttery sugar and then you've got something pretty. But then they go, I've got 16 pieces of this and there's me. And then,
For baking?
Yeah.
Yeah. See, well, I just really like decorating. I love, like, putting icing on and, like having themed things and making it all cute. But then, yeah, you have so much food and I'm like, I don't want any. And everyone's like, oh, no, I'm trying to be healthy. And I'm like, all right, going to eat it all.
What are we going to make now? Is this healthy?
It isn't bad, actually. This is tandoori cod, so it's grilled fish. So we've got a beautiful piece of cod. And again, if you didn't want to use cod, then any big, firm whitefish, monkfish is good to do this with. Or equally, it is one of those dishes where you could actually use chicken. This, it would work in the same way. Then we've got, for our marinade, we've got some lime, we've got some garam masala, we've got cinnamon, we've got some cumin, we've got some paprika, ginger, lime, garlic, and some yogurt. Then with it, we're going to do a basic raita with some extra bits into it. So cucumber, mint, coriander, ginger, lime, mango, red onion, and more yogurt.
Okay.
So first job, I'm going to give you nice experience. So one knee for the cod. We're going to come down the middle. So nature is a wonderful thing. It gives us a clue as to what we need to do.
Right.
So cut right down the middle there.
Great.
And then I need, let's just go into six big pieces.
Okay.
Right. Meanwhile, what we do for the marinade, we have a little bit of yogurt.
Come on, you can do this. Come on.
The pressure's on.
Be confident.
I am confident.
Can't do your thumb.
Can I wet? Hang on. My thumb is literally over here.
So, careful. What we do here. Pop all of those ingredients into there.
All of it?
Yes, please. And then, with the grater, grate a little bit of the ginger and a little bit of the garlic. So you're going to need about half of that. So that goes into there. Same with the ginger, and then the same with the zest of the lime. How are we doing?
Great. I'm nailing it.
I got the easy job. Thank goodness.
This is good. What you need... It's confidence. Imagine that you've just got a great a cappella arrangement of a song, and you need to be confident with that knife. Rather than kind of, at the moment, you're a little bit, wavering on your voice. You need that
diaphragm.
Yeah, diaphragm. Yeah, that's exactly what you need. So then, a little bit of the garlic grates into there, Scott, and then a little bit of the ginger. So grate a bit of ginger in as well.
Okay.
And then meanwhile,
wait, how much?
Beautiful. That's perfect. Meanwhile. Roll the slime and squeeze the lime juice. Your band members are laughing at you.
No, they're supporting us. More?
Have you not done this in America TV shows, cooking?
I think there's some, like on Food Network.
Well, we've never done it.
No, no, no.
God's like...
I think it exists, cooking.
Do they do cooking in America now? Have they started doing it now?
Kill it.
Would this show work in America, do you think?
Do what?
Would this show work in America?
Yeah.
I think so. People love food.
Yeah, they do love food.
The thing is, Tim, they've only managed to see sort of 20 minutes of it so far.
You know, this show goes on for 3 hours.
No way. It's a long show.
Yes way.
You know that.
Yes way. You got your work cut out, you don't get...
Right. I don't even know if I'm
that's
doing
fine. Okay, Scott, that's great.
Thank you for being supportive. That's what I needed.
We've mixed together our marinade ingredients. So you've got big, strong flavours in here.
Okay.
And then, Kirsty, prop all of the fish into there.
Okay.
And then give that a stir around. And what you do is you would then let this sit for a couple of hours. So all of those lovely flavours in there, the cumin, the coriander, the yogurt, the chilli, all those flavours will get into the fish. And that will give us some great flavour when we cook it. So once we've done that, let's imagine, let's pretend that we've let that sit for 2 hours. Then, simply, now I've soaked this parchment in water so that it doesn't burn when it goes under the grill. The reason I've done this, there's no skin on the cod. If you put it straight on the tray, it will stick. So when you try and turn it over, it won't work. This way, it means it won't stick.
You're nodding. You're nodding, saying, I have no idea what he's talking
about. No, I'm...
So then we have... So our cod goes on there. There's no need to put it on skewers or anything like that. And then we go under a really hot grill. See, those pieces are beautiful. Because they're big, large pieces, it means that you get a really kind of juicy flavour. But sometimes when you do anything like this, you cut things too small, and then by the time they've cooked, they just stop breaking down. This way, you've got a really kind of big, unctuous piece of meat. That goes under the grill.
A what piece of meat?
Unctuous.
What sort of animal is that?
It's from the unk. There's loads of those in Texas. Absolutely loads of them. Yeah, they farm them quite heavily now. Yeah. They only used to be wild. Now the farmed unk is a particular favourite. Now, with this, so that grill's a very hot grill. Grill it for about 6 minutes. Turn it in the middle. Then we're going to baste a bit of lemon, a bit of butter. This is our little salad. Yogurt in there. Knife skill. So mango, what we need to do with our mango. We get the mango. And mangoes are a bit of a pain in the backside because you've got to cut around the stone. So you're looking for where the stone is and you come down.
Okay.
And once you get round that, what we need to do, cut that in half and then scoop out the flesh like that.
Okay.
And then once you scoop the flesh out, I need to just chop it quite roughly like that.
Great.
Meanwhile...
Do I cut them in smaller pieces like this one?
So it's a little thinner so you can scoop out the flesh. Meanwhile, a little bit of herb chopping, some mint and some coriander, and all you need to do, hold it like that, Scott, and then simply roll the knife.
Got it.
Like that, so it's gentle.
Gentle.
You know, there's no rush, and you're going away all the time. Leave the point on
the board.
You all right there?
Yeah, I just don't want to...
Kill
myself. All's well. That's all right. How much of this mango do we need? Because I'm a bit worried.
Oh, not much. You know, we can get away with a little bit.
Now, you two are very talented, but your teammate over there, Kevin, quite exceptional because he's invented something called cello boxing. Is that cello boxing?
Yes, absolutely.
We got a clip, but can you explain what it is before we show?
Yeah, absolutely. It's playing cello and beatboxing simultaneously.
Is there a demand for that, do you think?
I don't know.
Maybe
there is
that.
Yeah, I love doing it.
It's
really fun to do.
All right, we got a clip. It is brilliant. Here we go, look. Gareth Seal, what do you make of that?
Oh, easy.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate that. Thank you.
More impressed with your cello playing.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate that.
That's pretty impressive stuff, isn't it?
So, yogurt, we have onion, we have cucumber, then I've put some lime zest in there, I've grated a little bit of ginger, I've got a little bit of garlic in there, we get more lime juice. So this is fresh. What we've got is lovely fresh flavours, but slightly heavy flavours with all of the tandoori stuff. Then we have this, which gives it a bit of lightness. We then add, great work, by the way, quiet, studious, deliciously done, mint, coriander, mango, all goes in there. This is delicious, it's fresh, it's tasty. Stir all that around. I've got big, full-fat yogurt because that's what I like, Greek style. You could use a lower-fat yogurt, you could use a smoother yogurt, but I quite like the way that this all works, and that is just lovely. That, with any kind of piece of fish, any piece of meat, is going to be delicious. On its own, with a bit of pita bread, would also be lovely. What we do, we get a touch of this into the middle of our plate, like that. And then the yogurt, the cod that we've grilled for about 8 minutes comes out, and the smell, of that is lovely. In here, we have some butter and lemon combined, and before we serve, we spoon that over. And what this does, the acidity in the lemon brings to life all of those delicious spices in there. Because at the moment they're quite heavy. You've got things like the ground coriander, the cumin, which are heavy flavours. What we want is to lift that. So when you eat it, you get a real nice freshness about it, which is what we're doing with this. And then we simply get all of these lovely pieces of cod. As you were saying about, even with big pieces like this, because the cod is cooked so well, it starts to break down. So we spoon that around here
to try this.
And then finally, a little bit of lime juice on there. Gareth, sprinkling of salt. Ladies and gents, don't be polite. Have a little dig in at that. Wow. See what you think.
Beautiful.
Go for it.
Oh, great.
Please.
Wow.
For you.
Oh.
This is about to be a good day.
For all of today's Sunday Brunch recipes, head to our website, channel4.com/Sunday Brunch. And don't forget, if you cook a recipe, to send us a picture. What do you think?
That's really good.
Is it good?
Nice, big flavour. Thank you very much. Yeah,